I wanted to put a finish on this. And what I did here was part by accident and part by design. I wanted to go ahead and lacquer all of the interior of this pressure box to seal the wood and to help keep it clean. So this and this was removed. All the interior surfaces were lacquered, as well the inside of the lid and all of this area. And then I forgot and lacquered this outside surface of the pressure box before I stained it. So I knew that was going to be a mess. So I went ahead and I sanded that down and I wiped it several times with lacquer thinner and with acetone. And I went ahead and put this walnut stain on here and then put lacquer on top of that. And it turned out fairly well. So I did the same thing on here. I went ahead and I lacquered it, sanded it down, rubbed it with lacquer thinner and acetone so I would get the same color. Trying to stain plywood, good luck. Plywood will soak up that stain like a sponge and all these spots will be real light and the rest of it will get real dark. And just as an example, I'll show you a picture of my flywheel or drive wheel that I stained with walnut and it turned almost black. It looked terrible. And I'll show you what I've done to correct that on the flywheel here in a moment. The take-up spool was mounted. I used a straight shaft to get the bearings in alignment. And then put the spool in there and made sure it turns freely. This piece is an empty spool I got just for being able to set this up. And there's a little spring right here. And that just keeps the spool pushed over to one side. And you do that so that your music, when it comes off, will be aligned with the tracker bar every time that you put a spool of music in there. The lid stay was mounted on here. It will just hold that in the up position. You can see these two wires that will push down on the music as it comes down across the music roll when the tracker bar is in position. This take-up spool will need to be in alignment with this spool. And at the moment, it looks like I may need to shim this over just a little bit. I use bronze bushings in here. For the crankshaft, I used a straight piece of rod to get all the bushings lined up in the first place. And then I've chosen to do the crankshaft in this fashion, which is pretty easy. A friend of mine made these. This was actually his design for these clamps, and they work quite well. If you do the welded crankshaft, you're probably going to have some distortion because of the heat. I don't see how you could avoid it. And if you use a welded crankshaft, you may be better off just going ahead using wood bearings. They're a little more forgiving. The crankshaft drives a little wheel here that turns that disc that has the Hoover vacuum cleaner drive belt mounted onto it. And that in turn drives a disc that turns the take-up spool. I have not mounted the plexiglass in here yet, mainly because I don't want to scratch it or get it dirty or break it. Rewind mechanism mounts here, and that Allen key will go in and out of this hole, and it engages with this hex socket that's built into these plastic spools. So when you push it in, you can rewind the music, and your clutch mechanism over here, you disengage the clutch so that you can rewind the music, and this will spin freely. The drive wheel will be here. There'll be a wood pulley here with a belt drive that comes down to a motor. Current plan is to have a disc slides onto the crankshaft, and this will be attached to the cranking wheel. The actual size of this pulley and the size of the pulley on the motor I'll have to play with that a little bit to get the playing speed correct. I wiped as much walnut stain off of this as I could with lacquer thinner and sanded it. Put some automotive primer on there, and then the gray Krylon paint from the spray can. And I think that looks a lot better than that mess from the walnut stain. Turns quite freely. The handle will be folded when the motor is being used. Or you bring the handle out and you can hand crank it when you take the belt off the motor. And again, the size of this pulley and the size of the pulley on the motor is yet to be determined. Not a whole lot more to be done on the pressure box. Needs a latch on here to hold the lid tight. There's a rod that comes back to here and pivots on this front part of the box. And that's part of the clutch mechanism that disengages that drive disc so the take-up spool will freewheel. And get those two discs mounted and that clutch mechanism completed. I put some rubber on here, which is used by the CNC guys. They use a vacuum table to hold their parts in place. It's real thin. I'm using that for the lid gasket. Put the two sides on here, mount the bellows and reservoir in place, and I'll probably make the three large pipes first so I can get the drive motor positioned without interfering with any of that. And the tracker bar, that will be an interesting project.